I'm going to talk my initiative in auto rickshaw segment. If you ever have been to India, I'm sure you would have traveled by a very tiny, you know, vehicle that's called auto rickshaws. These are the vehicles you'll find in thousands and thousands in number in Indian cities. These are very important in Indian context because this creates ample livelihood opportunity for millions of people in India. However, this sector has its flip areas because of being unprofessional nature by of the auto rickshaw drivers, the people, those who drive the rickshaws. Because of the unprofessionalism, commuters are harassed every day. The thousands of people, millions of people are traveling by these rickshaws. But then the auto rickshaw drivers, they are hated by the commuters because of refusal, because of not charging proper fare, because of taking through longer route, because of physical and verbal assault. So that's one of the reasons that people don't like the rickshaw, though it has a very important role to play as far as the moving of the Indian cities are concerned. I'm one among the victims of harassment of auto rickshaw drivers way back 2008 when I was a student of management. A very fine evening, I along with my couple of friends were going to have a dinner. And we hired a rickshaw from the gate of my institute. The rickshaw driver charged $25. While returning in the evening, around 9 o'clock, 9 p.m., we hired another rickshaw and he charged $35. There was a difference of 10 rupees. Being a student, I started arguing because 10 rupees mattered for me at the time. I started arguing with the rickshaw driver, why there is a difference of 10 rupees? He said, that's the amount you have to pay. He was very rude. I said, I'm not going to pay this amount because this is 10 rupees extra. So no, you have to pay. We had a discussion, and then after 5 or 10 minutes of discussion, I said, okay, let me pay this guy 10 rupees extra. Because then I started thinking, like me, there will be every day thousands of people in the city would be getting harassed. They will be hiring the rickshaw. And then you take to your home, and then they will start negotiating. There is no proper fare structure in the city. If there is a government mandate, but they don't follow that. So is there any way we can organize? We can offer a reliable and safer rickshaw to public? I came up with the idea, let me have, at least there would be certain good people in this sector who would be working for livelihood, who will be working for, you know, with honesty, can I organize these good people? I went and conveyed my ideas to a lot of auto rickshaw drivers. Out of them, 15 auto rickshaw drivers were finally ready to join me. I committed them, you join me, I promise your income is going to increase, provided you just stick with the fair, government fair structure. I'm going to give financial assistance. I'm going to give you some social security in terms of insurance, merit claim, etc. They were ready. The 15 rickshaw drivers, they joined my network. To my surprise, within a week time, I had a call from almost 100 auto rickshaw drivers. They wanted to join my network. I said, wow, I think it's going to work. But then, to offer them incentives, I didn't have money. So I started thinking, now, from where I'm going to bring, you know, money to offer them incentives, the incentive, the financial incentive and mediclaim and insurance that I was talking about. Then I thought, let me have some business model where I could get money from the market. I approached a couple of corporates that this is the model. If you give me money, I'm going to use this money for the welfare of this auto rickshaw driver. In return, I'm going to put your brand on these vehicles. They were agreed. So within a fortnight time, kind of, I started running 100 auto rickshaws on the road. People started demanding. Today, if you see, these are the auto rickshaw drivers, those who have not been to India. These are three-wheelers. We are here. After, I think this is fifth year of operation, since 2009. Formally, we launched this program in 2009. We have around 10,000 people working under this project, and we are in four cities. We are now going to start this project in the national capital of India. The objective of this project is to ensure safety and transparency in paratransit system, to ensure social and financial inclusion of auto rickshaw drivers and their family, to make auto traveling pleasant and passenger-friendly transport system, and to make auto drivers aware and responsible citizens. So this is the broader objective of this project where we are working on. Now, who gets benefited out of this project, and how? Like auto rickshaw drivers, What is the benefit? Why auto rickshaw driver should join us? And what kind of benefits he gets out of this project? So after joining the rickshaw the network, we make sure that the rickshaw drivers earns more money. So he should become prosperous. Why a rickshaw driver is cheated? Basically, he thinks that if he overcharges, if he takes a passenger through wrong route, he is going to earn more money. We make sure that if you charge as per the government fare, you charge as per the regulations, and you are going to earn more money than cheating the passengers. Now, what we do in this case, since they are working under one umbrella, under a brand, suppose somebody needs a rickshaw, he calls our rickshaw drivers, okay? So in that case, the number of tips increases. His number of trips increases. We have provided a lot of parking in the area, so people go, if they want reliable and safe auto rickshaw, they go to the parking area where G Autos is standing, they pick up rickshaw from there. Apart from that, we have a parking area at railway station, airport, bus stops, where the frequencies of these rickshaws will be higher. So in spite of charging the government fare and regular fare, their income is more than the people, those who are not following the government system. Secondly, the security reason. Since we are providing financial and social security, at the same time, if something happens, the organization, the group of 10,000 people are standing by their family. So they feel if something is happening, there is a support system working behind them. Apart from that, if they are harassed by the police, harassed by the touts, there's an organization working to safeguard them. So being with the organization, being with the G Auto network, they feel they are safer than being the unorganized. And last, but not the least, is the dignity. Earlier, they were being abused by the commuter. They were treated as if they are criminal, as if they are, an antisocial element. But now, because of working in a network or under a brand, people give them respect. We do not call them driver, now we call them pilots. So they are called G pilots. So people give them, respect. If they go to pick up someone during morning, people offer them coffee. So the kind of job satisfaction they feel now is much, much better than what they had earlier. So this is the kind of benefits that auto rickshaw drivers get. Now, what kind of benefits passengers get? So here, we develop the system, like what we are talking, refusal. Now, if you want to get rid of refusal problem, simply call our call center number. You get a rickshaw. You don't have to even tell where you want to go. You simply say from where you want to pick up. So even if it is a smaller distance, we provide the rickshaw. Safety. If you are booking a rickshaw, you get a link. You can track the rickshaw, where the rickshaw is going. We have provided, we have put GPS on the rickshaw. So this GPS system provides you the live tracking of the rickshaws. If you are sending women, if you are sending children on the rickshaw, sitting in a home, you can track where the rickshaws are going. So we use technology for the rickshaw. You can book, if you don't want to call, you can just go to our website, you can book rickshaw, you can download app, you can book auto rickshaw through app. So we brought technology in order to bring transparency and safety in the rickshaw. And the third beneficiary of these projects are business associates, those who have been funding us. So we providing a better visibility to their brand, and this basically money comes from the branding. Since this is poor man taxi, auto rickshaw is known as poor man taxi. Here we cannot charge a differential fare to customer, neither we can charge any fee to auto rickshaw drivers, because these are poor people working for their livelihood. So we have advertising as a model which takes care of our cost. So here the basic challenge of this project was how to manage the cost, whom to charge, and who is going to pay me. So here we came up with the cross subsidy. Don't charge to beneficiaries, neither charge to commuters, charge to someone else who already pays somewhere. So like the business associates, a lot of corporates are spending a lot of money for advertisement on television, on newspaper, magazine. So this is one of the best media and the cheapest media to get advertisements. So we manage, so the beneficiaries are business associates as well. Now, if you see what is the impact of this project over the last 5 years. So, see the cities like Rajkot, Gandhinagar, Surat, Ahmedabad, the cities where we are working, these are the cities which have never seen meter culture since independence of India. Now, within few years, within few months, we introduced meter system. People have started using meter system. Auto rickshaw drivers adopted meter system. Something that could not be done in last 60 years, 65 years, we have been able to do this thing in 3 years, 4 years. So that's one of the biggest achievement that we feel, that we have been able to bring a culture of meter system. Second is changing a behavior. Earlier, auto rickshaw drivers used to think that passenger is one time business for him, because he thinks that this passenger is not going to meet me ever. So let me charge whatever I feel. Now here, because he's working under a brand, he feels that the same passenger can come tomorrow. So he is going to be repeat customer, so I have to behave in a way. If I am not, then this customer can complain and I can be blacklisted from the organization. So now he is indirectly, in a way. Now reward for the honesty. Like earlier we used to read news in newspaper that customers, auto rickshaw drivers are involved in robbery, in this crime, that crime. Now because of this, because of G-Auto project, people are doing good thing, and now you'll find that in newspaper, you'll find coverage kind of honesty is the best policy. He's the rickshaw driver, has done something, you know, valuable to the passenger, and he comes on the front page. Here is the rickshaw driver. And so, like, there is a huge shift in the whole, you know, thinking of the society, media, people. They started thinking different way. So now they feel that if they are doing better thing for society, their efforts can be recognized. You know, people appreciate it. And that's one of the, I would say that's one of the best impact that we have been able to create this project has been felt. Now, over the efforts of last 5 years, on national level, the government of India has realized that there is a need to organize auto rickshaw. And the government of India has recommended to all the states of India to implement, to replicate G-Auto project, which is safer for the women, which is safer for the public. And it controls, it also helps in improving law and order of the city. So now we have been able to develop an ecosystem to organize auto rickshaw sector in India. Now the future plan, very soon in 2013, we are going to do is we are coming up with the sharing rickshaw, like still cheaper. Rickshaw is already a cheaper mode of transport. We are going to make it further cheaper by bringing technology and sharing. So with the help of technology, we are going to bring a sharing. And we are also going to launch free auto rickshaw service for cancer patients. So home to hospital, we are going to launch a service where auto rickshaw can carry cancer patient from home to hospital. That will be free of cost. We are going to affordable meal for auto rickshaw drivers is going to be the next. That's our plan for 2013. Thank you.